Well, hello. So I'm going to talk about the film I care a lot. It's from 2020. It is rated R. It's about 2 hours long. It's a comedy, mystery slash thriller. 78% of critics on Rotten Tomatoes gave a good review. The consensus being a searing swipe at late stage capitalism. I care a lot is an exhilarating pitch black comedy with a wicked performance from Rosamund Pike. And 36% of audience members gave it a good review. Audience members say Rosamund Pike and Peter Dinklage do good work, but they're acting in a dark and ugly story that doesn't give the audience anything to root for. That's so funny. I mean, I kind of agree with both of those consensuses. Even though I like the movie, I find the audience one consensus kind of relatable. Like, I can see that, but I still like the movie. Oh, this is a long premise, but I'll be brief. Poised with a shark-like self-assurance, Marla is a professional court-appointed guardian for dozens of elderly wards, whose assets she seizes and cunningly bilks through dubious but legal means. It's a well-oiled racket that Marla and her business partner and lover Fran use with brutal efficiency on their latest cherry. Jennifer Peterson, a wealthy retiree with no living heirs or family. But when their mark turns out to have an equally shady secret of her own and connections to a volatile gangster played by Peter Dinklage, Marla's forced to level up in a game only predators can play, one that's neither fair nor square. Funny. Yeah, so radar for violence and language. It's a comedy mystery thriller. It's in English, directed by Jay Blakeson. Yeah, so. Like I said before, the film stars Rosamund Pike, Peter Dinklage, and also we have Isa Gonzalez, Diane Wiest, Chris Messina, Isaiah Whitlock Jr., Macon Blair, Nicholas Logan, Damian Young, Alicia Witt, and directed by this guy, Jay Blakeson. Alright, I think that's kind of really it to talk about. I'm sure. Okay, I don't see accolades or awards. I just thought there would be. Okay, so my personal thoughts. I really do like this film because it's. I rarely do I see a film about capitalism and its critique of it in such an entertaining way. And of course, like, yeah, these characters are not people you would root for. Well, I would assume like maybe compassionate people wouldn't root for. As the audience members say, yeah, like. There's nothing in the film that audiences can root for. Yeah, because these characters are just very selfish, like, yeah, kind of a capitalist minded, like money profit first type of people. And like the and you know the main character played by Rosamund Pike, she does it in a legal way. She makes money legally, even though it really ruins the lives of those she gets the money from, again, in legal means, through legal means. And her eventual nemesis in the film is played by Peter Dinklage, who is the has connections to one of her sort of clients who she gets money from legally again. And Peter Dinklage becomes, yeah, like the psychological adversary for our protagonist, if you would call her a protagonist, which, yeah, I guess he would because, yeah, main characters in films, whether they're good or bad, I guess are the protagonist. Yeah, and I'm just laughing because it's just so refreshing to see a film like as they would as you know a lot of genre labelers call like a black comedy or a dark comedy. Or, you know, what I would say, just like a comedy that goes all in on the premise of going on film, on screen, like the repercussions of people who take advantage of, you know, these sorts of social institutions that, you know, political like groups rely on, you know, nations or countries or whatever. So it is kind of interesting, yeah, that in the career consensus they bring up late stage capitalism, like right there, like, you know, up front. And I didn't really think of it like that, but yeah, I agree. Yeah, I mean, definitely that is what this film is trying to make a point of. But again, I guess I want to say, like, this film is not for everyone. And I can say that with confidence because, yeah, like, most of the audience members did not really like it, even though I did, but, you know, this is my opinion. And the performance by Peter Dinklage, when I didn't know he would be in this film, so that's the only spoiler I'll say, so. apologies for spoilers. His character in this is so funny because I've never seen him play someone so, like, I guess mean. I don't know. I mean, he's usually like portrays sympathetic characters in the popular stuff he's been in, like whether it's like, I don't know, Game of Thrones or other films he's been in, but like Infinity War, the Avengers film, or the train station agent or whatever. Excuse me. Yeah, this is not a really well thought review, but yeah, you should check out I Care a Lot if any of that sounds interesting. Oh, by the way, one more thing. This film does explore the concept of how elders in retirement homes, not all of them, but like some of them, I guess, are being like very taken advantage of. Like they're taking advantage of, like, to a very high degree. And you know, I like how this film kind of explores that. So again, this film is a comedy though, even though it does make obvious points about capitalism. Like, for me, it was just fun to see the relationship and dynamic between this character and Peter Dinklage's character as they go head to head, trying to, like, you know, all for the sake of profit and money. You know, so it's not a perfect film, but it's just like the concept and the way they decide to make it like comedic is a refreshing, entertaining, you know, film concept, you know, for me. All right, so that's all. Again, it's I Care a Lot. It's 2 hours long. It's rated R. It's a comedy mystery thriller. Until then, take it easy, y'all, and peace.